The Houston flap. This flap, described by Houston 7, advances 0.8 centimeters and is useful for reconstruction of transverse guillotine amputations, as well as oblique losses, in which case its advancement may be even greater. One may criticize the classic technique. However, on several counts, 1. In our experience, the advanced skin does not attain good sensibility, particularly at its tip. 2. The pedicle that is left in place is prone to develop a painful neuroma due to entrapment in a scar subjected to pressure. 3. Frequently, there is an unattractive dog ear distally, and 4. Proximal coverage of the secondary defect with a skin graft on the pedicle may diminish flap sensibility. There are a number of solutions for these deficiencies. First, if the classic technique is to be employed, selection of the advancing side must favor the non-dominant pulp. Thus, in the case of the thumb, the longitudinal incision must be on the radial side. Second, it is possible to advance both pedicles with the flap 8, thereby preserving full flap sensibility and removing one potential neuroma from the contact area, albeit at the cost of diminished advancement. Third, the dog ear may be remedied by means of a rectangular excision of dorsal skin, which carries the added advantage of advancing palmar, sensate skin onto the area involved in pinch 9. Finally, in order to avoid grafting the proximal secondary defect, one may design a triangular flap adjacent to the longitudinal incision, since the axis of rotation of the main flap produces ample skin for closure at this site.